gonna be down there till Monday, right?
Monday.
So the only difference this year is because of my stuff, my MS stuff, we're having to take the trike, which I was kind of disappointed about, but it's safer because MS is so unpredictable. You don't know from day to day, so we're bringing the trike instead of the bike, but that's okay. We're still there and we're still going to have fun and whatever. So, the back is all filled, and I'll show you the trailer when we get there. The trailer has got the trike on it and my electric wheelchair. You know, if that's what it takes to let
we cool crippled up folks.
Wendell said we cool crippled up folks. That's okay. I just started a new medicine and we're hoping we'll be able to be back on the bike by fall rally. That's our plan. If not, that's okay. But I wanted to give you a glance on the first leg of going to Panama City for bike week. Here's the trike that we're taking. And there is the electric wheelchair. I don't know, I think that's kind of funny. All right, so we're fixing to have snacks and ride some more. Okay, it is time for us to stop. We stopped at Sonic. I'm gonna get something to eat. But everything's looking good. Straps are all still tight. Nothing much is going on, so we're gonna run up here to Sonic and get something to eat. Hey, we are officially in Panama City. We are on what, Front Beach Road?
Yes.
We're on Front Beach Road heading to our hotel. It's close though. We won't be too long getting there and getting unpacked.
Right on the other side of that big hotel right there.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we don't have far. It's been a pretty good ride.
Yeah, traffic wasn't bad at all.
Yeah, we didn't hit hardly any traffic at all.
There's
Angelo's. Oh, okay. Oh, I see it. We didn't hardly hit any traffic. We just kind of cruised on down here. We stopped in Alabama and filled up gas and got some like snacks and stuff. But then we just kind of cruised on down. It just don't seem like it took us hardly any time.
Well, you might have napped a bit.
Well, yeah, maybe.
All right, let me see here. I got two.
Yeah, I'm on my new MS medicine. Finally, I finally got it. But it kicks my butt. Yes, the other day, day before yesterday, I think I slept for 22 hours.
Yesterday,
22 hours. It just knocks me out and I can't help it, but I'm gonna try taking it. Now, that was a 7-day pack and I had to take one in the morning and one at night. But now I am up to the regular dose that I just take once a day, so I'm gonna try to take it at night and see if that makes it any better. I hope so, because I don't want to sleep the entire time I'm in Florida. But Wendell just informed me that I might have napped a little bit while I'm all the way down. Not too much, I don't think.
Not too much.
Yeah, maybe it's getting better. Yesterday I was gone, but we're seeing bikes, y'all. Of course, I mean, we didn't, a lot of people have already, you know, come down. They were coming down Monday and Tuesday and whatever. So we had a bit of a snafu. So we were supposed to come yesterday, but that's okay. We got down here today. But stay tuned and I will talk back at you in a minute. All right, we found the hotel. We always stay at Panama City Resort and Convention Center, or so anyway, they got the hotel part, and then they got the condo part over there. We don't ever stay in the condo part, but this is a really nice place, and they treat you good. The prices are equal to, or comparable to, pretty much anywhere else. So, and this up, we got a oceanfront view this time, and Wendell is checking us in, and I don't know, we're probably just gonna get our stuff unloaded, and they have like an off-site, if they still do, they have an off-site place where you can park your trailer. So we'll unload the trike and unload all of our stuff, and then we'll take the trailer around to the trailer parking, and we have a chain and a lock to put on that, which, you know, you can only be as safe as you can, because, you know, anybody can, you know, use bolt cutters and cut it off, but we just figured we would at least make it hard for them. Just kidding. I'm just kidding. But I hope everybody has a fantastic time down here at Bike Week. But above all of else, be safe. Don't get in a hurry. Don't, you know, trying to be silly. Don't try to impress people. Just ride. Just enjoy being here. There's always lots of wrecks and fights and different things. People get drunk and whatever. Just don't do that. I really hope everybody is safe and has a great time. You unloading the bike now?
Yeah, I'm gonna take the truck over there, empty.
Okay.
You wanna come check the car?
Yep. Yeah, I will. Make sure we got it all.
Oh, there they are.
You think they're gonna get us?
No, he can't even run, go upstairs.
So you think we're safe?
I think so.
But we are on the ground floor. You wanna take this? You gotta, there's your.
Okay, we are riding in my electric chair. Electric scooter chair. To get it up to the room. It's a pretty place. Alright. Yeah. I'm scared it was gonna sorry about the resolution. The door's open and then there's lights over there, so it, and back there, so. We are, where we're staying, they don't allow your trailers to stay on site. So we just had to unload the bike and bring the trailer over here to this off-site trailer parking, I guess. So he's undoing the trailer now, and we are going to go find some snacks and stuff to keep in the room and some drinks. And we're gonna be in for the night. I'm tired. Even though it's been a nice trip, I mean, it hasn't been a bad trip at all. We don't hardly have any traffic, which I was surprised because people are coming down for bike week, but it was nice. There's my husband asking this poor man that's working on his truck, and I won't video him, obviously, but seeing if he could help him. You know, bikers help everybody, so we were just making sure he was okay. Okay, here it is. You walk through the door, there's the bathroom, which I think is a little weird, right by the door. So, one double bed, and that's for like a little storage area and a mirror. A pretty beach painting. Anyway, so double bed, double bottom bed, and a single top bed. I think they're saying 7 people could sleep in here. There's no way. I don't know 7 people I want to be that close to. All right, so there's just a desk and a little lamp. We got our little fan set up. There's a little dresser drawer. And this is the only one, isn't it? So if you had all those people in there, what are they going to do with their clothes? Coffee pot. Microwave and refrigerator. We have a gulf side view. There's the pool. And just walk out here. There's the what?
Beach access is right there.
Yep, and there's the beach access right over there. And there's the beach. So, I'm excited. We don't have dogs this time, which kind of bums me out a little bit, but it's okay. So there's the ocean. You probably can't see it.
There's a boat on the ocean. Does that help?
See, that goes. There are the waves.
Made the light. My boys are pulling on your own.
me. Their stuff. Yeah. And so they take off the factory stuff. They just have their stuff for sale here in case somebody needs something. There's some tanks and seats and stuff. On a more serious note, a little bit more of a serious note. Last night when we were coming in, we saw a lot of police cars around a, I think it was a Waffle House, and they had taped it all off with yellow tape. And, you know, I was like, oh, you know, I hope they're okay. I didn't know if it was, I didn't know what it was, but there was a wreck last night, and I think it was only a one-man wreck or one vehicle, and he was on his bike, and he ended up passing away. And I can't get that out of my head. I just prayed for the families as they got that phone call. Today is going to be terrible, and it just, I don't know if the gentleman had, was married or had kids or anything, but and just say a quick prayer for that family. I can't get them off my mind. But I mean, everybody knows that it happens and it can happen, but when you see it, it's a little bit different. But I hope y'all are enjoying my little bike rally, and I'm glad to be able to share it with you. Even if you don't ride, it'd still be kind of cool though. Anyway, try to keep that family in your prayers if you don't mind. Check out what? Oh, that's funny. Clothing, novelty, stuff. There you go. Are we going to try to buy matching shirts?
Yeah.
Look, there's that. Isn't that one that I tell you I want every single time?
And you never buy it?
I never buy it. I love that shirt. I'm opening. But it's okay. I don't remember what it cost, but I'm pretty sure the reason it's still hanging there was because I didn't want to pay.
It was.
I didn't want to pay what they were asking for it. Oh. I thought it was going to like that, but never mind. I like that one too. Wendell and I usually try to find matching Harley shirts if we can. We usually can. Sometimes we can't. And we choose out of out of these. Oh, I like that orange.
Might be what your mama wants.
What sizes are they?
40 also. They don't say on the thing, they just put up every damn tag.
Oh, there's the size.
Huh?
I just found the size. I'm trying to find.
All the shirts on this chick, just different color shirts. Well, so I'm not really feeling it. I was kind of doing the green.
I need to get another bandana, but we'll look at the vendors for those.
Okay.
I imagine there's some keychains. I imagine they would have a better deal. Some tumblers. About done with this. I can only go for so long, and with it as hot as it is,
I want to find that in a soft rubber one.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Lots of tumblers. I'm done for the day. This year as I did last year, but anyway, we're headed to eat. I think we're gonna go to Shuffles.
We're going out.
I looked for the stuff. Thank you.
You too.
I looked that was in the cup holder.
Oh, okay.
And we are at Chuck'em. And they have lots of t-shirts and it's kind of a cool place. These are the oysters we always get. They're baked and they got parmesan, cheese, garlic.
Garlic butter.
Let's see what it says.
I don't remember what all it says.
Parmesan cheese, butter, garlic pepper.
And then you got like horseradish. And then these are new. What are they called?
Cajun? These are Cajun baked. Hey guys, we finished eating at Chuck'em's and we came on back to the room. Overall, I would say it was a pretty successful day for first day of bike week. We had a great time and we went to Harley. We haven't made it to Frank Brown Park. That will probably be tomorrow. But I just wanted to check in and let you know that we are done with day one. After we ate, I was pooped and so we was coming back to the room, but I was feeling horrible. But now that we're back in the room and I've cooled off some, I feel much better. But day one was a win. We had a great time. Good morning. Actually, it's afternoon already, but we're kind of taking it low and slow today. We are just now getting out. It's almost 1 o'clock, but we're going to go get something to eat at Wendell's favorite sushi bar. That's always a must when we come here, but we're going to go eat. And then we're probably just going back to the room to just chill out the rest of the day, because we're going fishing tomorrow for Wendell's birthday, and that's going to be out in the sun all day. It's going to be a long day, and you know, I don't do good with that. So we're just going to chill out today and not do too much, because if I get super tired today, then I'm just kind of adding on to it for tomorrow. So that's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna sit back and watch some TV, do whatever, maybe order something in tonight. But tomorrow's gonna be fun, but I can't do two really busy days back to back. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go eat and head back to the hotel for the rest of the day and kind of take it easy. Hi, honey.
Hello.
Hi. We are at Wendell's one and only request he ever makes.
Say I make lots of requests.
Say it, Shin. The name of the restaurant?
And Kishi. It's backwards.
Yeah.
So we'll make it upside down and backwards. And it looks like hieroglyphics.
Sean Kishi. I don't know. Anyway, Wendell just doesn't ask for much. He really don't. My nose is itching.
he doesn't ask for much, so we make sure we come here on our trip down here. This is the one place that he wants to go. And then we have our staples, like we went to Shuckin's last night.
All you can eat sushi, nigiri included.
Yeah, that's his thing. I don't eat sushi, but that's okay. They have hibachi too, so that's what I got. We ate Shuckin's last night, and I don't know what was wrong with me, because that is my favorite. Those oysters there are like my favorite, and I couldn't eat them. They didn't taste right to me. They were fine.
Wasn't anything wrong with them.
It wasn't anything wrong with them. It was just me. Sometimes my taste just gets off, and they were insanely salty. They were not. They were perfect. Just to me, they didn't taste right. But sometimes my taste just gets off. But anyway, I was a little bit disappointed. Not in the restaurant at all. Not there at all. It is what it is. So this is Wendell's one and only request. And then we always hit Sharkys. And that's our three main ones. Shuckin's, Sharkys, and here. And then if we get hungry tonight or something, we might order something.
Yeah. Well, I brought chicken wings back from...
Oh, that's right.
From Publix. If you can eat those, I don't know. Or maybe they were the hot, spicy, non-bread. I tried to get regular chicken, but they didn't have none.
I think they'll be all right. Yeah. So, we're going to eat here. And like I said a few minutes ago, we're going to take it easy and kind of chill at the hotel today. Because tomorrow is going to be a big day. It's Wendell's birthday.
Fishing.
And we go fishing.
Fishing.
Y'all know how it is. If you've been following me at all, you know how he is. And the fishing is one of my biggest...
Yeah,
one of the things
that's what you want to do.
That I look forward to the most. So, it's a little pricey. So, I told him, if we can't, we can't. But I really enjoy going. So, we're going to go tomorrow on his birthday. And that's kind of the biggest things of what we want to do. The couple eating places, fishing if we can. We always do something for Wendell's birthday. I mean, it always. Where was that place we ate for your birthday the first year we came? Was it Sharkys? You remember we ate out on the deck?
Yeah, that was Sharkys. Yeah, we were supposed to meet up with that guy.
Yeah, no Sharkys.
That never showed up.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
That's how Mama likes it anyway.
Yeah.
The wonton soup without the wonton.
You got the salad.
Oh, yeah.
The yummy salad.
Do you guys like ginger salad when you go to Chinese or whatever? It's really good. It's got a ginger-based dressing to it. I know that sounds bad. I know.
Yeah, you'd think it'd be horrible. But
I thought so, too, the very first time I got it. But it's really good. It's actually really good. So that's our plans. That's our plans for the rest of the day. And then tomorrow we'll be fishing. And tomorrow's going to be a really big day for me. We're going to be out in the sun all day, and I don't do good with that, but I did get one of those little neck fans.
Yeah.
I'm hoping that'll help.
There should be a breeze blowing out on the boat.
Yeah. So, anyway, that's what we're up to. Check you back in a minute. All right, so there's the ginger salad that me and Wendell have been kind of picking at. And this is my hibachi. I got steak and shrimp and fried rice. Jury's still out on the soup. I think we decided we didn't like it. I think it's some sort of broth, but it kind of has a little bit of a fishy taste, so I don't really like it. And can we take a second to appreciate that big bottle of soy sauce?
Liquid salt.
Liquid salt. I mean, have you ever?
No.
Like, that's serious.
I bet they got that stuff in a 55-gallon drum out there in the back. They're pumping it out with a
like a whale?
Yeah.
A hand pump?
Like one of those big barrel pumps.
I wanted to show y'all how beautiful these plates are. They do a really good job at presentation.
Can I get some more wasabi?
Wasabi? Yeah. Isn't it just pretty? I just think it's so pretty. I told him he couldn't eat anything yet. Okay. I showed it off last year too. So there's my hibachi and my salad.
Ice cream place.
It's
right there.
Oh, we might have to visit it. On Wendell's outing yesterday, going to get me some band-aids and Neosporin for my finger.
There it is. See it right there?
The orange?
Yeah, on the left. See right above the crosswalk sign?
Uh-huh.
See, it says Hershey's.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he was out getting materials to bandage my wound. Man, it hurt too. He found a Hershey's ice cream place. I see that in my foreseeable future. But anyway, we are going to one of my favorite things to do while we're down here. We always charter a boat and go fishing, and it's so much fun because you never know what you're going to catch. Or if you're like me, you catch the same fish three times. Not cool. But anyway, we're heading down. We always go fishing with Santa Rosa Charters, and we always use Captain Austin, which his brother's in with him too, and I'm sure he would be just as great. I guess this is just who we happened to get the first time, and so we are sticking to him. This is our either third,
but it could be fourth.
Yeah, I think it's the third one, but anyway, I come up with the idea that he needs to give rewards points. He needs to give rewards points when you book consecutively through him. I'm going to tell him that too. I'm going to tell him that. And it's Wendell's birthday. Happy birthday, Wendell.
Thank you.
So number one, it's Wendell's birthday. Number two, I think he should give rewards points. And number three, sounds like a good idea to me. I don't know. So, he's got incredible sense of humor. He's funny. He will put you on fish. If you're casting and you're not getting anything for two or three reels, then he's going to move. Hang on.
Why'd you sneeze on me?
I didn't sneeze on you. I didn't mean to.
What's that booger on my arm then? It was a booger, but it's not.
What? You're using a page out of my playbook. I couldn't help it. But anyway, we're going on a 4-hour excursion. They have four, they have six. Or was it four and eight? Is it four and six?
Yeah, I think so. They might have an eight.
Well, we did the six one time. Or did we just do four? We did four to see if I would like the six, because, you know, six is a bit long.
Yeah, and, we're just fishing in the bay, so we can catch our limit. I think our limit will be two redfish and four speckled trout, and we can usually do that in 4 hours. So if you do 6 hours, then you got a 2-hour boat ride.
Yeah.
So
I'm happy with the 4 hours. It's plenty fun. But like I was saying about Captain Austin, if he hadn't put you directly on fish, he's going to move. And he's going to move until he finds you fish. And he says that's
hungry
his
fish.
Hungry fish, that's what he says. And he says that's his job. Okay. I'm sure there are plenty of captains who really just don't care. They've got your money. You know? If you catch something, fine. If you don't, fine, you know? He's done his job. He took the boat out. You're in the boat. He took your money. But this guy really cares about, he really wants you to, you know, get fish and enjoy the experience and stuff. So that is what we're doing today.
I think we probably actually had one of our pictures on his website, because he took a picture of us. I don't remember if you caught a Jack Cremal and I caught a pretty good sized redfish, or
that's when we doubled up.
When we doubled, yeah, and he took a picture of that, so they may
still be on the website. I don't know. We gave him a glowing review because he deserved it. We do not give reviews very often, and we should, because anywhere we go, we read all the reviews.
We like reading them. We don't like writing them.
That's kind of hypocritical, I guess. But we read all the reviews before we do anything. But we don't ever leave them. But he deserved it, and we left a really good review. If he didn't deserve it, we wouldn't have left it. So our picture was up there for a while. I don't know if it still is. But anyway, that's where we're headed. And I will check you back soon.
There's not no red light down there, is it?
No. I forgot to tell you what happened to my finger. We went to eat last night. You know how you get like a little jagged place on your fingernail and you just cannot leave it alone? I kept picking at it and kept picking at it. And then it folded back and tore way past the quick right there. And it was bleeding. And it wouldn't come all the way off. It was attached by this little piece, and I couldn't hardly touch it, much less pull it off. So I had to just try not to touch it or whatever until we got back to the hotel. And Wendell carries his trusty little tool. What do you call it? Leatherman?
Yes.
Is that what you call it?
It's like a Leatherman, yeah.
Yeah, it's like a Leatherman, you know, and it's got that little pair of scissors in it. And he got that little pair of scissors, and when he closed it, it hurt so bad, I jerked my finger away, which I think is what tore it off. I about cried on that one. I definitely said some words I shouldn't have said, but it hurt so bad. But my amazing, loving husband that he is left the hotel and went to, where'd you go? Walgreens?
Dollar General.
Dollar General, and got some Neosporin with the pain medicine that's in it, and some Band-Aids, and he bandaged my little finger. I mean, I laugh at it now just because it looks funny, but it really did hurt. It really did. So we're heading to the marina. Well, Wendell said we're gonna follow this guy because he's local, and I bet he knows where he's going.
He wasn't going the same place we are.
Then we quickly realized he was not going the same place we were. So that logic doesn't always work. We've seen that bike a couple of places. It's a pretty bike. Obviously, there's a Jeep like mine.
Yeah.
Except my top matches. Obviously, there's tons of bikes down here. You know, Bike Week. But you wouldn't believe the amount of Jeeps down here. I mean, we just quit playing our game after a while because it was like every other vehicle was a Jeep. And I know they got Jeep Jam coming up, but it's like
2 weeks
from now. I don't know if just that many people live down here that has Jeeps, or I don't know, but there's a ton of Jeeps. I was telling Wendell, we don't ever hardly see one my color, the color of mine, or that looks as good as mine, in my opinion. And we just did. It was the same color, but it had a black top, and my top matches the color. But anyway, oh, you see all kinds down here, don't you? You really do. Some half naked. And, you know, they dress that way because they want the attention. So I'm going to give them the attention they deserve. Why else are you going to dress like that? They want the attention. But the people that work here, like work the bars and work the clubs and work all that, I mean, I'm sure a lot of them just need the money. And don't you think a lot of it's just seasonal too? Like they'll hire all this help to get ready for bike week and then after bike week.
Yeah, but there's stuff going down on down here all the time. Like yeah. Right after bike week comes Jeep week.
You know,
of course it was spring break was before, you know, bike week.
Yeah, I think it's a week before or 2 weeks before. That's true. So maybe people just come to like for the summer, like.
Yeah, there's always.
Work during the summer or something, but.
You know, and then, you know, at the end of May, school gets out, so then it's.
Everybody heads down.
Yes, game on from then until September.
Yeah.
So.
And by the way, don't judge people too hard. I can't stand that. I can't stand somebody judging somebody else. You don't know these people's story. You don't know their life. You don't know their story. You don't know why they may have to work jobs they might prefer not to. Don't judge anybody else. If it came down to feeding my kid or paying a light bill, better believe I would do it. Nothing is above you when you're talking about your kids or your life or anything like that. So keep that in mind. And that was today's PSA. Check you later. Okay. I keep popping on here because I keep thinking about little snidbits of information.
Little what?
Snidbits.
Snidbits?
Yeah.
How you spell that?
SNIDBITS. Snippets.
Snippets. Okay.
Or you can say snippets.
Snippets. Snippet in the bud. We just watched Andy Griffin.
We did.
Marty was snipping it in the bud.
We did, y'all. We watched Andy Griffith last night. We would have watched the Golden Girls. Well, we were watching the Golden Girls, but it went off.
Do you want a Burger King or a Taco Bell, or are you good?
I'm good.
Okay.
Are you hungry?
We
brought some crackers with us. But, so, here's a thought. The accident, I'm sure there's been more than this, but as of the news last night, there have been 3 motorcycle wrecks.
Fatality motorcycle wrecks.
3 fatal motorcycle wrecks. Keep them in your prayers. They've stayed in the back of my mind. I couldn't imagine getting that phone call. So be praying for these families, or if you don't pray, send good vibes or thoughts or something. But okay, so there's been 3 fatalities. Okay, but this look twice, save a life thing, motorcycles, it's fantastic, it's great, but it works the other way too. We just had a bunch of 6 or 7 or 8 bikes riding beside us and cut straight in front of us and looked at us like we were wrong. Didn't put a blinker on, didn't signal, did nothing. And like tried to push us over, just got in front of us like they own the road. Just because this is bike week.
And we had somebody turn on the, actually had a green light, but you know, it's a green light for each way, and he pulled out right out in front of a truck, and his truck had to slam on the brakes to keep from hitting him. He was trying to hurry, but he didn't have enough horsepower to hurry. If he ain't got it, don't do it.
So, let's respect the cage riders too. Yes, it's bike week, and yes, we come down and we have a great time, but you have to have a great time responsibly. Motorcycles are harder to see than cars. I'll give you that, you know, and you got to look more and listen more, but we're not it, you know. And those two riders, like what came over on us a while ago, they're what give us bikers a bad name. So, anyway, don't do that. Look for bikers, but pay attention to cages too, because they're down here on vacation just like the rest of us, and they deserve the same.
And they don't know, half of them don't know where they're going, you know? So they're not looking at you. They're not looking for you to do something stupid in front of them. Yeah. They're trying to figure out where they need to turn.
They're trying to figure out if they've passed their road. They're looking at GPS. They're looking at their phone. You know, they're as lost as we are. So just be courteous and be responsible and be observant to your surroundings and stuff, but just be respectful. That respectful and be safe. I think that's all it boils down to, so that everybody comes in the same condition everybody leaves in the same condition they came in, alive.
What's all your toenails?
Well, well,
you still got it. It's just slightly modified.
It's slightly modified.
Yeah. It's a little shouter than it was.
It's a custom job, y'all.
Yeah.
Not everybody will do it down here for you. Shh. You gotta know somebody. You gotta have to hook up. But anyway, just my thought. It's not all cage riders who are causing the problem. It's everybody just being careless and not wanting to be late, or not wanting to, you know, they're trying to get somewhere real quick. Happy hour's about over. I don't know. Just be safe and have fun. Okay. This is our marina that we go out with. I bet that's where we're going.
Grab that bag from me.
Hey, hey, man, how's it going?
Oh, good, good. Y'all down for bike week again?
We yep. are. Yep. Of course. Pretty. You're always one of my favorite stops.
Oh, yeah, well, I appreciate it. I look forward to seeing you guys. Normally, I have, five, six people on the boat.
Ooh, that's a lot.
It's a headache. It's a headache.
Yeah, that's a lot.
This right here is fly fishing with friends, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Like, we pitch you guys everywhere. All of our Facebook everywhere.
I appreciate it. It's like yesterday, I've taken the guys a bunch. But it's like two will sit here, two will sit there. Yeah, I can't navigate. I'm like, I always jump in there good. I cut up with them. I'm like, y'all turn this 24-foot boat into a 14-footer. I'm like, they're good as gold. I'm like, come on, guys. Let me navigate. Let me help you. We caught fish. They had trout for dinner, so hey, everybody's happy.
That's right.
Hopefully, last year it rained. Was last year around us off?
Yeah, you're exactly right.
It started thundering.
We had a storm come up.
I was looking today. It's been gorgeous, but I know that they said there could be pop-up showers,
yeah.
But we are in Florida.
Yeah, that's right. People always ask me, what's your favorite time to fish? Generally, May and October. Start getting June, July, August, you have them late after the thunderstorm. And that'll drive you bonkers.
And it's too damn hot.
Because that's like yesterday, seagulls. Hopefully they don't mess with us long yesterday, but they were just nonstop. And I said, I compare those seagulls to a storm. I've always had a storm. I gotta run over there. I may not want to fish over there, but I have to because of storm.
Storm, yeah.
It's like the seagulls yesterday. I'm like, we gotta get away.
Did it get hot down here for about 2 weeks ago?
The fishing started getting good, and all of a sudden we had a cold snap.
Yep.
And it was like a light switch.
Turned it off.
I mean, it was tough. Like the day, I guess 2 days.
I think that boat was out there last year, wasn't it? Nothing on this, right?
Nope. Fresh bait. Hopefully you put another trout in the boat. I knew just when I pulled up on it, it was just dead weight. I said, that trout will do some head shaking.
And Wendell's pulling in all the fish today. Check it out.
You're on the wrong side of the boat.
I know.
I got right out the back and it hadn't got a bite.
I did that last year too. I think I said, I need to come to your side of the boat.
That one just got bit.
Stacy
over there.
Stacy? Yeah.
Oh, it's wrapped around this.
Maybe.
No, it's not.
Got
the video?
Yeah. It's a stingray. So we caught our limit on trout within an hour of being on the boat, which is pretty cool. Then we're gonna go see if we can hit some reds somewhere.
Yeah, redfish.
Redfish, here we come.
Redfish with a big dot on their tail.
I didn't know that.
You knew that, but you'd forgotten it.
Oh, I probably did know that.
You'll remember it when you see it. When you see one.
Awesome. Okay.
This bird can have it your way.
Have it your way.
Got a big whopper speckled trout, and we got a limit of fish. Well, limit of trout. Gonna go get, see if we can find some redfish.
Yeah, we caught our limits on the trout within an hour. And so now we're going out, seeing if we can find some redfish.
This ship has been here since, like, I think he said the mid-60s or something. It was like a wrecked ship. And it's been there ever since. There's somebody else fishing.
Okay, so there's no rain in those clouds. That one was
back over here.
Oh, you have a
protected area, yeah. I got a girl I went to school with, her dad, on both sides of the canal.
Lift it up out of the water now.
No, I'll leave it in the water though, but I'll pull them out off and clean the bottom.
Clean it, yeah, get the marks as well.
Yeah, I'm going to get you a picture of all these fish laying out. I'm going to get you in the shit.
Fish out. What's up right there? We outdid ourselves from last year. Yep.
That's a bag of fish there now.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Here's this big aquarium. I think either once or twice we've sat at this table right here.
Yeah. There you go.
There.
Thank you.
Now you're getting to do it all. Now you're getting to do it all again.
I know. It was a recording. That's okay. Wendell's trying to hide behind the red dot. I told him it don't work like that. We always sit by this aquarium. But I was saying, I love this place. This food is fantastic. It's not one of our absolute must-haves, but we like it. Sharkys and Sharkys. Wait, there was one more. That we really like.
Sharkys and Sharkys and
your sushi.
Oh, sushi place, yeah.
So I was so disappointed last night at Sharkys though. Not because of Sharkys nor the food. Everything on their end was great. But my taste just was off, and sometimes that happens with this medicine. So if I lose weight because things don't taste right, I'm okay with that.
But I couldn't hear you, baby.
I just said if I lose weight because I don't want to eat anything, I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
No, I wouldn't choose that way. I don't know. I just go against our plate.
Do we need to have somebody take our drink order, or do we just...
Can you just one second?
Okay. Okay. Just making sure we weren't just sitting here.
Just doing it.
Yeah.
What's
on me?
It's good.
I mean, the aquarium's cool and the lake's nice, but they got food over there.
So, we need sustenance.
All right, over there.
She'll be over here for you.
Okay, thank you. Okay, here's my plate. Catfish fillets, we got potatoes, macaroni and cheese, just because I had to try it, and shrimp scampi, and crab legs. Honey, are you happy to finally be here?
Yeah.
Eating seafood on his birthday.
Seafood on my birthday.
That's it.
Mm. These are good. They'd be awesome if they were.
Are back in the room. Finally, we loved our dinner. I wanted to show you my wound. Wendell's about to wrap it back up. Graphic. Be careful. Just kidding, Mr. Way not. My fingernail just tore. I'm just kidding. It wasn't graphic at all. But that son of a gun hurt, though, I tell you. That restaurant was so good. It was better than what we remembered. And crab legs, oh my gosh. I about ate my weight in crab legs. And here lately, that's a lot of crab legs. trying to dress my wound over here. I hope you had a good birthday, honey.
I did. I did indeed. Pretty awesome birthday. Well, I thought you knew that. I thought you were planning that.
I was. Well, I said I hope you enjoyed your birthday. So, what was your favorite part of the day?
Well, it was. Because the fishing was awesome. The supper was awesome. Hanging out with you was awesome. It was all awesome.
Good. I'm glad you had a good day.
Yeah,
I know you won't. We always are in Florida for his birthday, so. But we went fishing. We limited out on all of our fish. What did we end up with? 16? 16 total?
We had 10, and then we were each allowed 3 speckled trout. 10 mangrove snickers? Smackers? And 3 each, 6 speckled trout.
That's what it was. And the weather was gorgeous. It was just so pretty. It wasn't too hot. When we get pretty hot, Captain Austin would say, "All right, y'all, let's turn the air conditioner on." And then we'd go real fast on the boat and it cooled off. But he was awesome. And of course, dinner was amazing. I need a council rescue workers. And then just being together and just kind of doing what we wanted to do. No pressure on trying to get everything done, you know. We've been so many times that you don't have to hit every single thing. Like, we're going to hit Frank Brown Park tomorrow. And then in the afternoon, I think we're going to go to the beach for a little bit. And that's pretty much going to be... We'll call it a wrap. We're not going home till Monday, but
this is our bag of boneless, skinless fish.
That is just 100% fillet.
Yeah.
So,
that's how much fish we have.
That is 100% fillet. He cleans them and fillets them, you know, right there. So, there was a restaurant he was telling us about that if we took them up there, they would cook them for us. You know, like right then. But we were pretty tired, and the sun, you know, it takes it out of you. So, we came back here and chilled out for a little bit, and then. Did you have to do that?
Uh-huh. Oh, did that bother you?
No, because you'll do it again. These bottles. No, don't get another one. I hate these bottles. He's going to do it again. Okay, thank you. You proved your point. I'm gonna hurt him. I hate these. The sound of these just gripes my skin. But yeah, tomorrow is Frank Brown Park and the beach. And then Monday.
Wake up and go home.
Yeah. Monday.
Wake up, load up.
We're going to head home, and we won't have to, you know, hurry and get home. We're just head back home, because Mama's procedure is
Tuesday.
So, I hope y'all have liked coming along on our bike week with us. I've enjoyed bringing you along. I like, it's okay. I like recording it and documenting it, so I can share it with everybody else. But, oh my gosh, we're so full. I am so full, I can't move.
Yeah.
But, all right, check you later.